Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you. And see, again I'm here to teach you SST Standard 3, Chapter 18. And the chapter name is National Symbols. So today we will start from the national emblem in this video. So please guys, watch this video till last and we will learn much more about the national symbols. Now, take a 1 rupee coin. You just take a 1 rupee coin and look at the images on it, and then after you can see the images inside the rupees. The symbol with lions that you see on the coins is our national symbols. So when you will see the symbols with lions on the coin, that is our national emblem. It is seen on coins, currencies, notes and all papers of the government. So national emblems, it can seen on the coins, in fact on the currency notes, and in fact on the all the papers of the government. It is the official seal of the government, means it is the official sign of the government, or official design mark which shows a person or an organization. So it can show that yes, it is belongs from the government. This emblem has taken from the Ashokan pillar as Sarnath. So the national emblem, this has taken from the Ashokan pillar at Sarnath. Did you know it's there? We can see. Vande Mataram is the name of our national song. I know I have told you early that national song we just sung on occasionally, like on Independence Day, on Republic Day. So the Vande Mataram is what? The Vande Mataram is our national song, and it was written by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. So it's important, it's for general knowledge. You can take here and you can write down the VVI that Vande Mataram is the name of our national songs. And it was written, the Vande Mataram, it was written by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Now, look at the picture of the emblem carefully. You can see that, you can look at this picture here, this one. You can look this picture carefully. Now, there are 4 lions back to back, but we can see only 3. So you can see this emblem carefully, then you can see there are 4 lions, front, right, left and back. But we can see only 3, the front, the left and the right. So we can see only the 3 lions. Below the lions is a wheel with a horse and a bull on either side. You can see here, if you have the book, then here the wheel is there and beside this bull is there. You can see in the emblem. So the phrase Satyamev Jayate, which means truth alone triumphs, is written at the bottom. So please underline it. The Satyamev Jayate, it means you see that in this, it is written here in national emblem. Here you can see that Satyamev Jayate. So it means that the truth alone triumphs. So please underline from the phrase Satyamev Jayate, the phrase Satyamev Jayate, which means truth alone triumphs, truth alone triumphs, is written at the bottom. Next is our other national symbols. Other national symbols like the national animals, national birds, national flowers. Now, the national animal is the tiger. So, we know that our national animal is tiger. It symbolizes bravery and strength. So, the tiger, it shows, it is a symbol of brave and a strength. Sadly, tigers are being hunted and killed by poachers. So, sadly, we know that it's very sad that it was killed by the poachers, means a person who illegally killed animals, fish or somebody else on land. So nowadays the tigers are being hunted and killed by the poachers. To protect the tiger, a government program called Project Tiger was started. So to protect the tiger, The government has started one program which is called the Project Tiger. It was started. After that, there are many tiger reserved in the country like the Sundarbans and Ranthambore where tigers are protected from hunting. After that, when government has started these all the program, then after the many tigers, in fact the many birds it has reserved in the country like the Sundarbans and Ranthambore where the tigers are protected from being hunted like a zoo, and the government has protected these all things in these all the Sundarbans and the Ranthambore. Next, a national bird is the peacock, which is known as for its beauty and pride. So we know that the national bird is peacock, and it is known for the beauty and for the pride. This bird is also protected in government because they have just made the zoos so that the poachers they should not hunt these all animals. The peacock dances when it rains. We know that the peacock is dancing when it's rain, and it is a beautiful sight to see it dancing with its features spread out like a fan. So it is very beautiful that we can see a dancing peacock dancing with its feathers spread out like a fan. Next is, our national flag is the lotus. It is a symbol of purity. So the next is our national flower, and the national flower is the lotus, and it is a symbol of purity. It grows in muddy ponds, but it always beauty and clean. So it always grow the lotus. It is always grow in muddy ponds, but it is always beauty and clean. So that's why it is our national lotus. The lotus is also offered to Goddess Saraswati, the goddess of learning. So we just offered these lotus to the Goddess Saraswati. Goddess Saraswati is the goddess of learning. Next, we should be proud of all these symbols and respect them. So we should always proud to be an Indian, and we should always respect to our national symbols and always respect them. They show that India is a big and beautiful country. The national symbols, it shows that India is a very big and beautiful country. They make us feel proud to be an Indian. So the national symbols, it makes us feel proud to all the Indian peoples to be an Indian. So we should always respect to our national symbols. And your chapter has completed. I hope you guys had understood. So here new words is there, you can write down from the book new words. So let's start with the exercise. So first of all, the first is true and false. So take out your pencil. Now you can complete in your book. Whenever this that I will give you the mode, you can write down in your copy. So the first is, a national flag has four equal bands. Then it's false, because a national flag has only three equal bands. So you can write down the F. Next, Janagana Mana is our national anthem. Then it's true. Then write down the T. Next, the national anthem was written by Rabindranath Tagore. Then the answer is T. Then write down the T. D, the tiger is known for its purity. Then it's a false, because the lotus is known as for its purity. So then write F. Next, the peacock is our national bird. Then it's a true. Then write T. Match the answer. A is false, B is true, C is T, D is false, and E is true. T. Second is, the Indian flag is dash in shape. Then the answer is second number. It's rectangular in shape. B number. The three colors on our flag are dash, white, and green. Then the answer is first number. It's saffron. C number. The dash is our national animal. Then it's tiger. The first number. The tiger is our national animal. D number. The peacock is known for its Dash and pride. Then the answer is beauty and pride. E number, dash is our national flower. Then the lotus is our national flower. So only 1, 2 I am giving you. The 3, 4 I will give you on next time. So till that, take care of yourself. Complete this homework in your fair copy. Take care of yourself. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.